个指挥就说，哦，感谢主你来了，可以帮忙做圣工。他说，他们就说，哦，有时候我要回母会聚会。
And then so they say, oh, good, you're here for service. And then they said, oh, well, sometimes we'll still go back to the other one.
因为他们服事太累，有时候以教会做避难所，这样子呢，可以休息一下。
And sometimes they're too busy, and so they will use the other church as a place of sanctuary.
有时候我们活在人间呢，有时候会觉得很辛苦。
So sometimes living in this world, we may find it to be very tiring and difficult.
有时候要服事神也没有力量。
And sometimes in serving God, we find ourselves without strength.
那我们可以想象当时的以色列人回来自己的故乡，他们有时候连最基本的生活保障都没有。
And we can think of the Israelites that sometimes when they returned back to their country that they did not have the basic necessities sometimes.
那神又要让他们来热心教会的工作。
And then God wanted them to very diligently work for the church.
有时候手会很软的哈，会手软。
And then so sometimes it seems that they will be very weak.
所以我们看到第三个信息啊，神就借着哈该先说跟他们讲讲。
And then so we see a third message from the prophet Haggai.
明天早上我们来谈第二个，我们先来谈第三个。
Tomorrow morning we'll talk about the second. First, let's talk about the third.
我们来看哈该书的第二章。
Let's look at Haggai chapter 2.
这是七月二十一日哈，神的话临到先知哈该第二章的第一节。
And so this was in the seventh month on the 21st of the month.
那我们跳过来，先跳过来读第四节。
And first, let us read verse 4.
你先读哈，第四节。
Verse 4. Yet now be strong, Zerubbabel says the Lord, and be strong, Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest, and be strong, all you people of the land, says the Lord, and work, for I am with you, says the Lord of hosts.
你看，主啊，在这边连续讲了三次啊，刚强，当刚强，要刚强。
And so here the Lord says three times, yet now be strong, and be strong.
对，无论是对所罗巴伯，这是行政人员呐。
Whether it was talking to Zerubbabel, who was
administrator, 或者是对这个大祭司，这是宗教人员
，or to the high priest, which is this religious leader,
那或者是所有的百姓
，or to all the people of the land,
就好像神站在在这边对诸位弟兄姐妹讲
，and it is like Jesus speaking to us here.
我们的姐妹啊，你要刚强
，sisters be strong.
我们的弟兄啊，你要刚强
，brothers be strong.
我们这边的老人家，你要刚强
，elderly be strong.
年轻人也要刚强
，youth also be strong.
因为我们有时候都觉得手很软弱
，and because there are times where we feel truly weak.
我们自己都这么辛苦了，还要来关心教会的工作吗
？And that we are all working so hard, and we still have to take care of the church's work.
就像我们早上说的，有时候撒的种多，收的少。吃不好，穿不软，还要来做教会的工作吗
？And then, so even though we sow a lot, we do not reap much, and so we do not have enough to eat, or we do not have enough to wear, and do we still care about the things of the church?
所以我们用这个题目哈，你要刚强，彼此来学习。
And so we will learn based on this verse. Yet now be strong.
我们来分享人常常会软弱，因为现况而软弱。
And so many times we will become weak because of our situation.
那我们在分享神叫人刚强。
And then we will share about how God calls us to be strong.
我们在分享为什么人可以刚强的原因在哪里。
And then we will also share about how is it that we can be strong.
好，来，我们来看第二章的第二节。
We look at chapter 2, verse 2.
第二节，第三节。
Verses 2 and
3. 第二节，你要晓谕犹大省长撒拉铁的儿子所罗巴伯和耶撒达的儿子大祭司。并剩下的百姓说，所以这个信息是给所有的人。
So verse 2, it tells us that this message is for all of the people.
第三节
Verse 3.
你们中间存留着的，有谁见过这殿从前的荣耀呢？现在你们看着如何，岂不在眼中看为无有吗？
前头 Verse 3. Who is left among you who saw this temple in its former glory? And how do you see it now? In comparison with it,Is this not in your eyes as nothing?
这里谈到人软弱，当然很多原因，他强调两个原因。
And here it talks about the reason for our weakness. There are two reasons.
就是你用现况跟过去做个比较，有时候你会觉得很无力感。
And the first is when you compare previous times to the current times, you may feel very weak.
你看过以前所罗门王那个金子贴的那个圣殿吗？
You see this, the temple that Solomon built, which was outlined in gold.
哇，那个如果哦，你在山下看向耶路撒冷，那夕阳下面，你真的看到整个金子那个颜色反射那个阳光，真的是可以说是。圣殿是金碧辉煌的。
And then so if you look at it at the city of Jerusalem, and then you can just see that the whole mountain is reflecting all of the golden colors.
真的很漂亮。
And it truly is very beautiful.
这些可能有几个八十多岁、九十岁的曾经看过以前的殿呢。
And there may be those who are 80 or 90 years old who have seen this previous temple.
那现在你看哦，只有地基了。而且已经15年荒废的地基啊，十几年荒废的地基啊。
Now all you see is this desolate foundation that is left over.
你会觉得，哎呀，这个怎么，我们建有意义吗？
And then so you think, is it worth it to even work on it?
所以有时候我们比较啊，就会以前呢，我们就会觉得很难过，很失望。
And so when we make comparisons to before, then oft many times we will be very disappointed and discouraged.
我记得1985年我来过 Houston.
And I remember I came to Houston in 1985.
你都不晓得那房子多便宜啊。
And you don't know how cheap the homes were then.
我说我们讲过去都会觉得过去的日子比较美好。
And then so when we talk about the old days, sometimes we always often think that they are better.
所以比如说以色列百姓出埃及的时候，
And for example, the Israelites, when they departed from the land of Egypt,
天天是玛纳玛纳玛纳
every day they ate manna, manna, manna.
我想说，哇，以前我在埃及，在弱锅旁边有葱姜蒜西瓜，哇，这个现在天天玛纳玛纳玛纳
And they said that we used to sit by the pots of meat, and there was all of these things that we could eat, but now every day it is manna, manna, manna.
实在是很厌烦呐。
And so it is very annoying.
所以当我们比较的时候，你会觉得日子过不下去。
And so when we make these comparisons, then we may feel as if we cannot go on any further.
这是第一个问题，他们为什么会软弱。
And so this is one of the first reasons why they will become weak.
今天我们也是一样的。
Today is the same for us.
你总会觉得过去的日子比较好。
We always think that the old days are better.
那第二个问题就是说，你看现在岂不看为无有吗？你看到的是情况呢，你一直看负面的部分，你会更软弱。
And then the second is that we always look at the negative side of things, and the more we look at it, the worse it gets.
真的，我们刚淹过大水哈。
And so we just went through a flood here.
如果你一直在看那个负面的东西，可能你在这个大水情节不晓得走多久才走得出来哦。
And if you continue to look at the negative side of things, I don't know how long it will take you to get over this flood.
那其实事情真的有时候可以两面看。
But oftentimes we truly can look at things from two sides.
在困难当中，我们也有时候会看到神的恩典哦，蛛丝马迹的恩典。有时候我们不要光看困难，我们要眼睛调一下。看到在困难当中神的恩典。
And that in times of difficulty, we can really see the blessings and the grace from God.
你看那个十二个探子探迦南地啊。
And we look at the 12 disciples, 12 spies who went to go into the land.
每个人看到的事实都一样。
All of the facts that they saw were exactly the same.
城墙高大，城民高，城墙高，城人也高大。
They saw a large city wall, and they saw the people were very large.
他们看到物产非常的丰富。
And they saw that the land, it was very fertile.
但是两个人就说，感谢主，赶快进去把它占了，因为这块地是神应许我们的。
And two of them said, let's hurry up and go, because God has given us this land.
可是十个人说，我们哦，看他们，我们像蚱蜢啊，他们看我们也像蚱蜢啊。
But then 10 of them said that when in their eyes, we are just like grasshoppers.
他们看我们也是了。
And
what, 我们看他们也是。
They see us as grasshoppers and we see them as giants.
所以这个怎么打怎么征战呢？
And so how can we win this battle?
所以看同样的事情可是分析的结果是不一样的。
And so they are looking at the same exact situation, but their thinking is different.
但是如果我们眼睛一直看那个困难的地方哦，你越看心里就越慌哦。
But the more that we look at the difficulties, then the more anxious we become.
你会想象一些可能从来不会发生的大问题哦。
You may begin to imagine some problems that would never have occurred.
所以他们就说啊，摩西啊，你把我们带到这里，让我们死在刀下吗？
And then they cried out to Moses saying, did you bring us out here to die by the sword?
其实这个事情几乎在他们的整个占领迦南地的过程几乎 几乎那个比例很小了，就是那个发生的很小了。
But it was actually a very small event in their time taking over the land of Canaan.
我们来看一个经文哦。
And let's look at verse.
耶稣雅记的五章十三节到十四节。
And look at Joshua chapter 5.
耶稣雅记五章十三节到十四节。
Joshua chapter 5 verses 13 and 14.
五章十三节到十四节。
Chapter 5 verse 13 to 14.
五章十三十四。耶稣雅靠近约利哥的时候，举目观看，请读。
Verse 13, and it came to pass when Joshua was by Jericho that he lifted his eyes and looked.
你想他看到什么？
What do you think he saw?
他举目观看，他看到城墙高大，城门紧闭了。
And when he looks up, he sees this large city walls and the gates are shut.
六章的第一节就是这样记载的。
This is what was recorded in chapter 6, verse 1.
但是神就不让他这样看了。
But this is not what God let him see.
说不料有一个人手里拿有拔出来的刀，对面站立。
What he sees is a man stood opposite him with his sword drawn in his hand.
耶稣亚到他那里问他说，你是帮助我们的还是帮助我们敌人的？
And Joshua went to him and said to him, are you for us or for our adversaries?
所以我们学到真的你举目看观看你看什么？
And so we truly learn, when you lift your eyes and look, what do you see?
真的你常常看到眼前的困难呢？
Oftentimes, all we see are the difficulties ahead
of us. 不料什么意思？不料就是说神就是不让你看那个，你看我手中的刀，看我，看我手中的刀。
But God wants us to look at him to see the sword drawn in his hand.
你看他，看着他手中的刀，你就有勇气啊。
When you look at God and you see the sword drawn in his hand, then you have bravery.
因为他后来讲说，不是你帮助我，是我来带领你哦。
Because he does not say that I am here to help you, but it says I am here to command your army.
所以弟兄姐妹，圣经到底的道理到底带给我们什么？
And so, brothers and sisters, what does the teachings in the Bible bring to us?
其实圣经的道理就带给我们哦，你凡事哦，真的，我们要看阳光那一面呐、啊。不要看阴暗那一面。
And then so it tells us that we do not look at the we should look at the sunny side of things, not at the shadowy side.
真的，你面对阳光，阴影就在你后面哦。
And truly, when you face the sun, then your shadow is behind you.
你看阴影，你就背对，你就看不到阳光了。
If you are facing your shadow, then you cannot see the sun.
你还记得一个故事啊？那个以利沙被敌人团团围住了吗
？And do you remember the story where Elisha was surrounded by the enemy?
仆人一大早起来说：“哀哉我户啊，我们完蛋了啦！”
And then the servants woke up in the morning and he said, "Woe is us."
那以利沙怎么说？
What did Elisha say?
神啊，你打开他的眼睛。
He said, "Lord, please open the eyes of
this young man." 那他看到与我们同在的比敌人还多啊。
Let him see that those who are with us are more than with those with them.
所以神打开他眼睛，看到满山火车火马保护着他们呢。
And then so he truly his eyes were opened and he saw the mountain was filled with chariots of fire.
所以我们环境再不好哈。
And so no matter how bad our situation is,
我们学习要看神给我们的恩惠，神给我们的盼望，神给我们的阳光。
We have to learn to see the hope and the grace that God has given us.
我以前听过一个故事啊。
And I have heard a story before.
在早期有一个美国公司派两个人到非洲去查看这个鞋子的市场。
That's early on, and there were an American company sent two men to Africa to see the shoe industry.
两个人看到是同样的一个，就是会说没有穿鞋了。
And what they saw was that it's the same thing that nobody is wearing shoes over there.
哦，所以一个人就报告了，完蛋了，这里根本没有市场，因为没有人穿鞋。
And so one of them reports back that it's an impossible market because nobody wears shoes.
另外一个说，哇，太好了，会说都没有在穿鞋，所以我们有好多人可以买鞋。
And the other person said it is a wonderful opportunity because nobody is wearing shoes. We can sell shoes to everyone.
真的呢，你那个观念哦，决定你的观念决定你是一个有活泼的人，活在阳光下还是活在阴暗里面的人呢？
And then so truly, our perspective really defines whether we live in the light or in the darkness.
啊，所以我们真的眼睛要看着耶稣基督了，看着他的刀哦。
And so truly, our eyes need to be upon the Lord Jesus Christ and the sword that He is wielding.
我们当传道人也是一样呢。
And for a minister, it is the same.
有一段时间啊，小弟在一些教会都是两三百个人在聚会的教会。
And for a period of time, I was in churches where there were always 200 to 300 members attending services.
我是一两百个人呢、啊，就人比较多了。
Well, there were many people attending service each week.
那个讲道理哦，都越讲越大声啊。
And the more the sermon, as the sermon goes on, it gets louder and louder.
可是我
But then also for a period of time, I was then transferred to areas with a very small population. And if you are not careful, you will start to speak softer and softer.
你看观众，你就觉得，哎呀，这个，这讲不下去了。
Because you look at the congregation and you just think, I can't go on.
你都看着主耶稣基督,
you are not looking at Christ.
你就看到教会的未来, 教会的,
you don't see the future of the church.
所以我们看哪里呢?
And so where do we look?
那问题是神要人刚强了,
and the thing is that God wants us to be
神不知道你经历,不是不知道你经历的困难,
God does not, it is not that God does not know that we have encountered difficulty. It is not that God does not know that the Israelites went through a tough time. But even at these times, you must continue to serve.
所以一而再再而三讲,刚强,要刚强,要刚强。
And so he says again and again that you must be strong, be strong.
你看历代以来神都要人刚强了。
And so throughout history, he wants us to be strong.
他怎么跟耶稣亚讲的?
And then so what did he say to Joshua?
你当刚强。我们来看一下,这个经文很好,耶稣亚记。
And let's look at this verse in Joshua.
耶稣亚记的第一章,
Joshua chapter 1,
第六节,
verse 6.
耶稣亚记第一章第六节,
Joshua chapter 1, verse 6.
第一章第六节,
chapter 1, verse 6.
你当刚强,因为你必使百姓承受那地为业。 就是我向他们列祖所启示是给他们的，请读。Verse
6, be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give them.
第七节,
Verse 7,
只要刚强大大壮胆,
only be strong and very courageous.
第九节,
Verse 9,
我岂没有吩咐你吗? 你当刚强壮胆,不要惧怕,也不要惊慌。
Verse 9, have I not commanded you, be strong and of good courage, do not be afraid nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
为什么神要一而再三次的跟耶稣要讲,你要刚强,你要刚强,你要刚强?
Why does God say to Joshua three times, be strong and of good courage, be strong, be strong?
耶稣要看多了啦。
And Joshua's,
he saw a lot.
He has seen a lot in his life. That the Israelites are truly a very stubborn people. And that in those 40 years, how many times did they want to kill him? And as a helper, he was already encountered all of this. If he is now the leader, how much more will he face?
所以怕,怕,不敢做。
And so he is afraid. He does not want to do this.
神就叫他, 哦, 你要刚强。
And so God tells him that you must be strong.
你看哦, 那个大卫要死之前跟扫罗门也这样讲啊。
And then we look at David, when he was about to die, he also said the same to Solomon. He said that you must prove yourself a man.
Prove yourself to be a man. 这个好像比较简单讲,你要做个像个男人。
And he's saying that you must be manly.
其实他也很软弱啊。
And so he is actually very weak.
有人说所罗门王当王的时候可能还是二岁,有人说十八岁,有人说是九岁,就是很年轻啊。
And then so some people say that Solomon was probably still very young, 18 or 19 when he became king.
他自己也说,你看国民,人民这么多,像海边的沙这么多,我怎么带领呢?
And then he also said it himself that there are so many people, how is it that I can lead them?
所以神,他的爸爸也要让他做一个男人,做个大丈夫啊。
And then so David encourages him to prove himself to be a man.
所以弟兄姐妹,今天我们彼此鼓励哦,我们也要 靠着主刚强啊。
And then so today we also must encourage one another to be strong in the Lord.
我们那个下垂的手, 那个花酸的腿啊, 我们要靠主把它挺起来。
That our legs and our arms that are weak, we must, through the Lord, raise them up.
要彼此劝勉啊。
And then we must continue to encourage one another.
小季现在年纪比较大的时候, 突然觉得说, 我立了一个志向,要立一个志向。
And as I've gotten older, I felt that I need to make a determination.
那个志向就是要立志对太太好一点。
And that determination is to be better to my wife.
所以现在每年,以前当传道都很少在请假, 现在每年哦, 都会拿假期要带太太出去走一走。
And so before, I used my vacation very sparingly. But now every year, I take some vacation to take my wife and go around.
我小时候有个梦想,就是带老婆到巴黎的。 那个叫做什么？有一条街叫什么？ 那条街，小时候常常读文章说很美的一条街叫什么？香榭大道。
And so as a child, I had this dream that I would bring my wife one day to Paris, to Champs-Élysées.
香榭，我们叫香榭嘛，香榭大道。啊，所以我就想说，好，我在那边租一个五星级的饭店。
And so I thought, okay, I'll get a five-star hotel there.
然后带老婆去巴黎玩。
Bring my wife to Paris.
感谢主了，真的这样做了。
And thank God, I have done it now.
但是哦，看到那条大道实在是太失望了。
But I have to say that after seeing the street, I was very disappointed.
我还记得我住纽泽西的时候哈。
And I remember when I was still living in New Jersey.
我们家门口那一条小道。
That's in the little alley in front of our house.
那个春天来的时候啊，每一棵树都先长花再长叶啊，那个花都是不同颜色的，有紫色的，有黄色的。好漂亮一条街啊。
And then so the trees on that street that they would start to bud before they grew any leaves, and then you would start to see flowers of all different colors, and it was very beautiful.
我记得我读书的时候，一读到这个什么香榭大道这种，都觉得很 romantic. 哇，那个道路多美，多罗曼蒂克。
And then so I remember whenever I was reading in my textbooks about this street in Paris, I would just think that it is such a romantic street.
去那边很失望，在美国这种路看多了，你知道。
And then so when I saw it, I was very disappointed because I've seen many of these types of streets in the States.
但是还有凯旋塔可以爬。
But then there's also
凯旋塔 yeah. Arc of Triumph.
The Arc de Triomphe.
那有人就警告我们，你们年纪大了哦，要向右转，不要向左转。向右转可以坐 elevator 可以上去，向左转要爬楼梯。
And then so we were warned beforehand that since you're a little older, you should take the right instead of the left. On the right, you can take the elevator instead of the stairs.
可是没有注意听哪个一下就往走了，然后就开始爬了这样子。
And then, we didn't listen very carefully, so without knowing it, we went to the left, and then we started going up the stairs.
我记得应该是99阶还是100阶哦 ，step 有99还是？
I think there are either 99 or 100 steps.
那跑到将近50的时候，我看着我老婆，老婆看着我。
And when we got to about halfway up, then I looked at my wife, and she looked at me.
这个上期也50，下期也50。
And then both ways are 50 more steps.
现在已经爬不动了。
And I already can't climb anymore.
怎么办呢？
So what do we do?
要彼此鼓励了。
And so we have to encourage one another.
我们再加油，休息一下，加油。
And so we take a break and then we continue on.
再往上走，真的走到上面去，那个视野突然就开了。
And then as we walk up, then as you get to the top, you see that the view opens up.
你从那个凯旋塔那里可以看到 Ivory Tower， 可以看到那个埃菲塔。
And then so from the top of Arc de Triomphe, then you can see the Eiffel Tower.
就觉得很喜乐，因为克服的困难。
And then you're very joyful because you've overcome this difficulty.
有人说什么叫英雄啊？
And then so some people have asked the question, what is a hero?
他们说英雄的定义就是比别人多坚持五分钟就是英雄了。
And people have said that a hero is one who persists for 5 minutes longer than everybody else.
征战的时候，那多那个五分钟就是决定胜负的时候。
And then so in a battle, then this 5 minutes can be what determines a win from a loss.
为什么神一直鼓励人你要坚强？
Why is it that God continues to encourage us to be strong?
常常在我们最需要的时候，你最需要的时候，你更要坚强。
Which is in our time of deepest need is when we need to be the strongest.
因为你不坚强，你的心会更软弱。
Because if we do not be strong, then we will become even weaker.
我们看箴言的24:10。
And we look at the book of Proverbs.
箴言24:10。
Proverbs chapter 24:10。
箴言24:10。
Proverbs chapter 24, verse 10.
24:10.
Chapter 24, verse 10.
请你读。
Verse 10.
24:10.
If you faint in the day of adversity, your strength is small.
这边提到说，你在患难之日若胆怯，力量就微小。你越怕越没有力量。
And the more you are afraid, the less strength that you have.
我就想到以前我们在台湾考大专联考的时候，或是高中联考的时候。
And I remember that in Taiwan when we were taking our
SAT 啊。
Like our SATs.
那个有的人真的会害怕呢。
And there are those who truly get very anxious.
他怕到一直拉肚子哎。
And they are anxious to the point that they have diarrhea.
考试一直拉肚子怎么考啊？
And then so if you have diarrhea when you are testing, how do you test?
真的你越怕会越没有力量啊。
And so the more you are afraid, the less strength that you have.
所以怪不得神要人坚强，要 鼓励我们，我们要彼此鼓励了。
And this is why God encourages us to be strong and why we must encourage one another to be strong.
可是小弟也体会到，不是说你不想害怕，你就不会害怕呢。
But I also know that it is not just because you don't want to be afraid that you will not be afraid.
那个英文叫 panic attack， 有时候人会经历那个所谓的那个，我中文不知道怎么讲，那个突然之间那个你没有办法控制自己，就一直会冒冷汗，心跳加快这样子啊。
And then,
你没有办法帮忙帮助自己的。
And so there are things called panic attacks where you cannot control it, but your breathing goes out of control and you get cold sweats.
我这一辈子就经历过那么一次。
And I've only had it
经历过那一段时间呢。
Or one period of my life.
我记得我以前在一个药厂上班。
I remember I used to work at a pharmacy.
那我写一套程式。
Or
write some coding.
And I used to write some code.
那他们正在测试我的所写的东西。
And so while they were testing my code.
哦，那真的很紧张呢。
And it is very, very stressful.
为什么呢？
Why?
因为我知道如果通过了，我就可以继续留下来这个公司。没有通过，我要捡铺盖走人呢。
And I know because if I passed, then I could stay there. If not, then I had to walk.
那这个公司真的很好哦，好像一个真的很好的一个公司。
This company was a very good company.
我用这个公司来办绿卡。
This is the company that I used to get my green card.
所以我这个测试关系着我人生的未来了。
And so this test would affect my future.
那不是故意要紧张，你就是一走进去办公室哦，很自然的就心跳加快，手冒冷汗。
And so it's not that I wanted to be more nervous, but the minute I walk into the office, then my heart starts to beat faster, and then I start to have cold sweats.
突然不知道怎么办呢？
And then all of a sudden, I don't know what to do.
唯一的方法哦，就是把门关起来，跪下来祷告。
And the only thing I can do is to close my door and to kneel down and pray.
或者是在电脑面前开机之前呢，写一些经文来勉励自己。
Or before I turn on my computer to read some Bible verses.
经过这样一两天，那慢慢的心情才平静下来。
And it was only a few days later after doing this that I was able to calm down.
所以我们真的要刚强，因为你在患难的日子，你又胆怯哦，那这只有更糟糕了。
And so we must be strong because in times when we are afraid, then if we are not strong, then we will become only weaker.
神让你坚强不是用嘴巴讲，坚强坚强不是这样子而已哦。
And then so when God wants us to be strong, he does not just say it with his mouth, to be strong.
他给你原因啊，为什么你可以坚强。
He gives us a reason why we can be strong.
我们看哈该书第二章。
We look at Haggai chapter 2.
第四节谈到你们都要坚强。
Chapter 2 verse 4 says that we must be strong.
第二章第五节，为什么你可以坚强的起来呢？
Chapter 2 verse 5, why is it that we can become strong?
他说这是第二章第五节。
Chapter 2 verse 5.
二章五节，这是照着你们出埃及，我与你们立约的话，那是我的灵住在你们中间，你们不要惧怕。这边他先提到说，你想想看哦，在出埃及的时候我曾经跟你们立约过。
And so here first he says that when you came out of Egypt I covenanted with you.
神在他们出埃及跟他们说什么呢？
Then when God led the people out of Israel, what did he say to them?
他说呢，我像老鹰啊，把你们背在翅膀上面呢，然后呢，以后你们要做我的，做圣洁的国度，做我眼中的宝贝了。
And then so he says that I have carried you on my wings like eagles, and then you will be my
you will be the treasure of my eyes.
You'll be the treasure of my eye.
那个中文翻的不太一样，英文就是说你要做我眼中的宝贝了。
And it says that you will be the treasure of my eye.
但是你也要做祭司的国度哦。
But you also must be a nation of priests.
你要听我的话。
You must obey my word.
你们愿意吗？
Are you willing?
摩西就问百姓，你们愿意吗？
And Moses,
就签约了哦，签约啊。
Moses asked the people and to sign this contract.
百姓说愿意啊。
And they said we are willing.
就好像在神面前签那个约一样了。
It is like they signed this contract before the Lord.
那神就说，如果你们遵守我的话，我要怎么祝福祝福啊？多少祝福？什么锅碗瓢盆呐？你出外打仗啦？什么都要祝福，如果你不听我的话，什么什么什么都会发生不好的事情。
And then so God told them that if you obey my word, then I will bless you in this way and this way. If you do not obey my word, then this will happen up to you.
那你再回想历史，是不是这样子呢？
And you think back on history, did this happen?
你们在没有亡国之前，我岂不说不听我的话就要被踢到各国去吗？
Before you had this country, didn't I say that you would, if you do not obey, you would be dispersed among the nations.
我岂不说早就说好了，将来你们要再回来这个地方来建造圣殿吗？
And then didn't I say that you would return here to establish this temple?
你看我跟你们立约的话，今天有没有实现？
And then you look, these words that I have covenanted with you, have they not been fulfilled today? Why is it that we can be strong today? And in the history of the Bible, can you find one promise where God has lied? We look at the words that God spoke to Abraham.
你的子孙要很多,
that your descendants shall be as many as the sand on the earth. Or the stars in the heavens.
有一个人,你的后有一个人,全世界要因他来得到福气。
And then out of your descendants, there will be one man whom the whole world will receive blessings from.
你的后又要成为一个大国,
and then your descendants will become a great nation. 这块地要成为他们的土地, and this land shall be their land.
我请问这么多应许亚伯兰活着的时候,哪一个应许?
And I ask you, out of all of these promises, which one of them did Abraham see with his own eyes while he was alive? Not a single one.
我再问,
then I ask you again, which of these promises did God not fulfill? Every single one was fulfilled.
所以弟兄姐妹,
and so, brothers and sisters, what is God telling us today?
虽然你现在看不到神的应许在你身上实现,可是神应许只要你信得下去,做得下去,
even though you cannot see the promises of God being fulfilled upon you today, if you continue to believe, every single one will be fulfilled.
如果在历代以来,你曾经发现到神是一个背约的神啊,
and so if in history you see that God was a God who went against his covenants,
你怎么可能有力量继续走下去以后的路呢?
Then how could you have strength?
吓死了!
How could you have strength to continue on? You would be so afraid. But you know that God is not a God who goes against His word. He is a faithful God. And so in times of difficulty, you can be strong because He is your reliance. And so what promises are in the Bible?
你信得下去吗?
Can you continue to believe in them?
他说不要为生命忧虑, 吃喝穿。
He said, do not worry about what you will eat or drink.
你信得下去吗?
Can you believe in this?
我常常觉得这是最简单的道理, 但是最大的一个, 对我来讲是一个最大的, 最大的福气的应许啊。
And this is, to me is one of the biggest blessings that He has given us.
因为现在人最缺乏的就是安全感。
Because what many people lack today is a sense of security.
神就是说, 我就是你的安全感。
And Jesus, God has said that He is our security.
在我里面, 你就是没有忧虑。
That in Him we have nothing to worry about.
你信得下去吗?
Can you believe this?
耶稣说在世上有苦难。
Jesus says, in this world there are tribulations. That in Him we have peace.
你信得下去吗?
Can you believe in this?
耶稣说我不撇下你做孤儿。
And Jesus says, I will not leave you as orphans.
你信得下去吗?
Can you believe in this?
如果他过去没有背过约,
if in the past He has never broken a covenant,
你可以抓住这些应许继续依靠神吗?
Then can you continue to hold on to these promises to believe in Him?
如果你真的信得下去,
if you continue to believe in Him,
你真的会有力量啊,
then you truly will have strength.
他说你要刚强,
He says that you must be strong.
不是空口说白话啦,
He is not just saying empty words.
但是我们要学会抓住神的应许祷告。
And we need to learn how to hold on to the promises of God in our prayers.
我去迈阿密听到一个见证。
And when I went to Miami, I heard a testimony.
有个姐妹啊, 她结婚很久都没有孩子。
There was a sister who was married for many years, but she did not have any children.
她慕道的时候都不敢跟主耶稣求孩子。
And when she was a truth seeker, she didn't
dare not.
She did not dare to ask Jesus for a child.
因为她觉得自己跟这位神没有关系了。
Because she felt that she did not yet have a relationship with this God.
她受洗的那一天,
the day that she was baptized,
她很勇敢,
she was very brave,
很有信心,
very full of faith.
哦,神啊,
she said, Lord, today I am your child.
我知道我很爱,
and I know that how much my parents love me, and I know that you must very much
我知道求这个孩子也不是妄求,
love me. And I know that asking of this child is not something I'm asking out amiss. Because this is a blessing that you give to mankind.
我要一个,
and she said, Lord, I want a child.
所以她很有信心抓住这个, 就是相信啊, 然后就求啊。
And so she believed, and she with faith, she prayed for this.
真的有一个, 就是在那个聚会当中有一个非亚裔的同龄哦, 也不认识他, non-Asian.
And then so there's a non-Asian sister who was in the congregation too.
他们也不认识啊,
and they do not know each other. Or they don't know each other very well.
奇怪的神开他的眼睛, 怎么看到这个, 这个, 他也不晓得他祷告, 祷告什么, 就看到这个姐妹呢, 在他前面怎么抱一个男婴孩啦。
But she didn't even know what she was praying for. But suddenly her eyes were open, and she saw her carrying an infant child.
这个在灵里面，不是真的抱住一个男婴孩。
And so this was in the spirit. It wasn't, she wasn't physically carrying a male child.
祷告完之后，她就跟那个姐妹讲，哎，我怎么刚刚看到你手里有一个男婴孩？
And after prayer, she said, how is it that I saw you carrying this male infant just now?
那姐妹真的很感动了。
And this sister was very touched.
所以有时候我们 对神的能力还是要有信心。
And so we still need to have this belief in God's strength.
我们再看第五节。We
look at verse 5.
那是照着你们出埃及，我与你们立约的话，那时我的灵住在你们中间，你们拜访。为什么我们可以刚强呢？
And so why is it that we can be strong?
神说，那时我的灵在你们当中，当我的灵在你们当中，你们就有力量了。
And so he says, so my spirit remains among you, do not fear.
我们都会背，是不是？一章八节，圣灵降在你们身上，你们就必得着能力。
And then we all know from Acts chapter 1 verse 8, it says that when you receive the Holy Spirit, you will receive power.
我们知道神的灵不是胆怯的灵，是刚强仁爱谨守的灵。
And we know that the spirit of God is not a spirit of fear, but of power and of a sound mind.
所以真的，你没有力量的时候，你真的很软弱的时候。
And so when you truly do not have strength, when you are truly very weak,
真的没有，有时候真的没有什么方法嘞。
And sometimes there really is nothing else you can do.
你跪下来祷告。You
kneel down and pray.
你真的祷告到灵的深处啊。
And then you pray until into the depths of the spirit.
你真的会从神那边感受到力量。And
then you truly will feel the strength from God.
这是很多人的经验。This
is the experience of many people.
神的灵在你们当中。
And that God's spirit is among us.
你刚强得起来。You
can be strong.
这不是你的力量。This
is not by your own strength.
我就想起小弟第一次用英文证道的时候。And
this reminds me the first time that I was giving a sermon in English.
当时我们叫做 Hosanna Outreach.
And it was during one of our Hosanna outreaches
在南加州,
in Southern California.
我还记得当时那个听众特别多，因为南加州联合起来举办。
And I remember that time there were more attendees than normal because it was a joint Southern California venture.
那我也是临时被通知。
And I was also called up at the last minute.
就是没有剩下多久的一些多少日子才被通知了。
That there weren't many many days before that I could prepare.
你知道人家说那个叫 number one phobia 是不是？说第人世间第一个最害怕的事情是什么呢？
And then so you know what they say the number one phobia in the world is?
就是公众的演讲了。
It is public speaking.
说实话，我以前也是很害怕，就是了。
And to be honest, I was also very afraid of this before.
更何况是讲英文呢？
And how much more so since it was in English?
能够祷告啊。
And so I prayed.
那我就记得我要上去证道之前。 我有一个习惯，就是要回头看观众。我要先预备好到底有多少观众，免得上来一吃惊，然后就讲不下话。
And so I have the this habit where before I go up, I look back at the congregation to see how many people are sitting there. Otherwise, once I go up, if I see a lot of people, I might get in shock and then not be able to say anything.
另外一个现象就是呢，上台之前我老是会跑厕所。
And then another habit is I will also go to the bathroom beforehand.
那个紧张就会这样子啦。And
so when I get nervous, this is what happens.
所以那一天就是这样子。And
so this is what happened that day.
可是很奇妙。
But very strangely.
我几乎也没有，就是那是很特别的感受了。And
that time, I had a very, it was a very special feeling.
真的，一上台，当用奉耶稣的名证道之后，讲完这一句话。That
once I stood up on the pulpit and I said, "In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak."
我以前小时候唱歌什么，我有平安如江河，我有平安如江河。
And then so there's a children's song that says, I've got peace like a river.
我心里一直在想什么平安像江河, 江河跟平安怎么连在一起?
And then I used to wonder about this. How does peace, how is peace like a river?
请你帮我解释一下。peace怎么像江河。我不了解什么peace叫江河。
And so I didn't understand what it meant for peace to be like a river.
可是那一天我真的有那个感觉嘞。
But that day I had this feeling.
我真的发觉到有一股好像热流, 就好像江河，一股一股涌到我的心头啊。
And I felt this this current flowing into my heart.
Warm
this warmth flowing into my heart.
Warm current, 就一股一股这样，那我就觉得好像很温暖、很稳这样子啦。
And I felt very stable.
那所以就 没有害怕。
And then so I was no longer afraid.
所以神的名真的很好用。
And so God's name is truly very useful.
祷告真的有效。
And that prayer, it is very effective.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们神的灵在我们当中，我们可以刚强。
And so brothers and sisters, that we truly can be strong in the Lord.
我们再看第六节。
We look at verse 6.
第六节。
Verse 6.
万军之主如此说，过不多时，我必再一次震动天地，沧海与旱地。第七节。
Seven.
我必震动万国，万国的珠宝都必运来，我就必使这殿充满了荣耀。这是万军之主说的。第八节。
Eight.
万军之主说，银子和金子也是我的，这殿后来的荣耀必大过先前的荣耀。
Nine.
在这个地方我必赐平安。这是万军之主说的。我们先请读第六节。
Verse six.For thus says the Lord of hosts, once more, it is a little while, I will shake heaven and earth, the sea and the dry land. Verse 7, And I will shake all nations, and they shall come to the desire of all nations, and I will fill this temple with glory, says the Lord of hosts.
到这里哈，这边一直强调一句话说，神必震动，神有能力震动了。
And so here it says that he will shake.
他可以震动万国。
That he will shake all the nations.
他也可以震动人心。
That he can shake the hearts of men.
所以你害怕的事情，因为神的震动，本来很困难的事情，会变得没有困难。
And then so the things that you are fearful of, these things, that God can shake them away.
实际上讲，王的心在神的手中如龙沟的水随着转动一样。王的心神可以震动王的心
And then God can shake the hearts of the kings.
他的心像龙沟，像那个trench 里面的水
then,
随着他那个在转动
and then his heart will be like the water following the ways of the trench
所以你看神可以震动古列他就让百姓回家建圣殿
and then so you see that God can shake the hearts of the king to let the people return home
你还记得有个坏蛋要害莫迪改神就震动那个王的心读历史读到莫迪改对他有这么多恩惠他也没有报答莫迪改
And then we know that there was an evil man who wanted to harm Mordecai. And it just so happened that God moved the hearts of the king to read about the history of how Mordecai saved his life.
所以神真的可以震动各样的环境，各样的人，让你的问题不再成为问题。
And so God can truly shake up the environment and shake up the people around us so that our previous problems are no longer problems.
所以他有能力震动了。
And so he has the ability to shake.
真的呢，我们要信得下去神的能力。
And so we truly must continue to believe in the abilities of God.
小弟到纽约读书的时候，那个学校很注重这个 liberal arts， 很注重这个文学。
And so when I was a foreign student in New York, my school was very strong in liberal arts.
他那个要英文写作1到10分，你一定要6分，无论你什么时候去考，反正你一定要考过6分，你才可以毕业。
And then so there was an essay that you had to write before you could graduate, and you had to get at least 6 out of 10 points.
那我就去拿那个 ESL 写作的课程。
And so I went and I took ESL.
那我就去考试了。
And so I went to go take this test.
考完之后我就去查分数。
And then so afterwards I went to go see what score I got.
5分，差一分。
And then I saw my score. It was a 5. And then I thought, oh, I was off by 1 point.
我就头低低的走在走廊上面。
And then so I just put my head down and I was walking through the corridor.
怎么遇到我那个 ESL 那个英文老师
？And then I met up with my ESL teacher. I just happened to see my ESL teacher.
他就问我你考几分
？And she asked me what grade did you get?
我说对不起老师，哎呀，你教的这么好，但是我只有考5分。
And I said, well, sorry, I know you taught me very well, but I only got a 5.
他突然说，来，我带你去查分数。
And then he said, well, come with me. Let's go take a look at your score.
真的带我去查分数嘞。
And then so brought me to go look at our score.
你知道那个考卷都是助教改的吗
And then so the scores are all given by
teaching assistant.
The teacher assistants.
那他是应该是副教授吧
And so he's probably an assistant professor.
他那个老师啦。
Oh, this teacher was an assistant professor.
他一去也没有讲什么，就跟那个助教讲说，这个学生你怎么给他5分，你要给他6分。
And then so he went up to the teacher assistant and then said, How is it you gave him a 5? You should give him a 6. And then so I didn't have to take it again. With that one word, then I got a 6.
所以我说这个神可以震动人的心耶。
And then so I thought, you know, God really can shake the hearts of men.
不过这个这样有一个坏处，就是我现在的英文写作还是停留在5分就是了。
But one of the bad sides is that my English is still stuck at that level 5.
但是小弟弟就说：“真的，我也没有想到要遇到那个老师，我也没有想到要透过什么关系 来啊得到好处。
But I really wasn't even looking for that teacher that day, and I wasn't looking for any help in getting my grade.
但是考试之前，小弟是有祷告的。
But before I took my test, I did pray.
神是听祷告的神呢。
And God is a God who listens to prayers.
神也是可以震动人心的神呢。
And He is a God who can shake the hearts of men.
心动一动，我就及格了。
And then with a little bit of shaking, then my grade was good enough.
所以我们要刚强的起来。
And so we must be strong.
这边又提到说，神可以预备资源呢。
And then here it also says that He can
prepare for resources.
He can prepare for
他说金子银子都是我的。
He says silver is mine and gold is mine.
说实话，我们说建殿哦，我们有时候弟兄姐妹最害怕就是资源不够，这个钱不够，你怎么建殿呢？
And then so when we talk about building this temple, then a lot of times what we fear the most is the lack of resources, the lack of money.
小弟当传道这么久，就是在布鲁克林之前哈。我从来没有经历有一次帮地方教会我就帮忙的教会要建殿
And I've been a minister for a while, but this time at Brooklyn was the first time that I've been a minister where they were trying to build a temple, build a church.
小弟调去的前几天前一个月，那个前面的传道就跟弟兄姐妹就更加 sign contract 要买一个1.62的一个 million 的一个建筑物。
And a few days before I was transferred over, then the church had signed a contract to purchase a building for $1.62 million.
那当然我也了解说他们还有多少钱嘛，哈。
And of course, I understood how much money they had.
他们应该我算算看哦，90+50+100，他们大概只有20-30万哦。
And they probably had $200,000 to $300,000.
当然他们也知道说母会会帮忙他们10万的。
And of course, they understood that that the other church would help them
with
another church would help them
with.
Oh, the mother church, their mother church would help them with 100,000, which is Queen's Church.
那也会借他们，应该是再借十万，给他们十万，再借十万这样。
And they would give them 100,000 and also lend them 100,000.
啊，这样应该就50万了嘛，哈。
And so this is about they are at they have about 500,000.
这个他们手上肯定有的啦。
And this would be cash on hand that they could have.
啊，所以那个，当然前面的传道他真的很有信心哦。
And so the minister before me, he has a lot of faith.
他跟弟兄姐妹讲啊。
He told the brothers and sisters.
耶稣教会建堂从来不是问题，同心合意才是。哦，建耶稣教会建堂钱从来不是问题，同心合意才是问题。
He said that, whenever establishing a true Jesus church, money is never a problem. It is just a problem of unity.
当然，我们因为他的话也很受感动了哈。
And of course, because of his words, then we were also very touched.
但是这次我也真的是觉得很讶异啊，说哇，这个。神要震动人心哦，真的金银都会来。
But I also realized this time that, you know, if God wants to shake the hearts of men, then the gold and silver will just come.
你知道大概六月底签约吧，哦。
And I think we signed the contract at the end of June.
大概九月的时候，今年九月哈。
And then in September of this year.
九月底啊。
Towards the end of September,
我们钱大概就筹够了耶。
That we already had collected enough money.
我们在这一段当中筹到90万现金。
That we collected $900,000 in cash.
50万贷款哈。
And
都是教会弟兄姐妹借，教会借的都是不用利息的。
And $500,000 in loans from other churches, that are interest-free loans.
我真的没有想到这么多嘞。
And I did not realize there would be so much.
南加州有个教会哦，那个奉献$10,000给布鲁克林教会。那是信徒大会同意通过奉献$10,000给布鲁克林教会啊。
And there was one of the churches in Southern California, after going through a congregational meeting, they donated $100,000 to Brooklyn Church.
在夏威夷有一间教会，他们自己没有会堂哦。
And then in Hawaii, there's a church that doesn't have a building yet.
他们还没有会堂，他们奉献$20,000。
That they also offered $20,000.
哇，我真的是被他们哦，应该算是吓一跳，也是很感谢这样子。
And I think that it is very shocking, and it is, but also very, we are also very thankful.
有时候真的不晓得为什么神这么爱那些比较贫穷的教会哈。
And sometimes I don't know. It seems like God really loves those churches that
我讲这
段话 do not have as much money.
不是说休斯顿教会同样也是这样了哈。布鲁克林因为很多弟兄姐妹都是。赚最低薪资的啦。
And then, because especially in Brooklyn, there are many members who earn minimum wage.
所以弟兄姐妹在谈这个事情，他们也知道这里是有需要的地方了。
And so when we are discussing, then they know that this is something that's somewhere that needs their help.
感谢主，那个上礼拜已经closing escrow，已经都 都已经买完了。
But thank God, last week, then everything was closed.
我以前听了很多见证啊。
And before I had heard many testimonies.
当然我也相信了哈。
And of course I believe them.
但是经历之后，不只是相信，是 wow， 你会 wow， what's going on？ 这个怎么会这样？这个有时候你很难理解到底怎么回事。
But having seen it versus this time is just wow, what's going on?
有个弟兄我去问他说，哎，你们教会听说很多存款，可不可以跟你们教会借一借？这样。
And then so I had gone to a brother, said, "Hey, I hear you guys are doing pretty well. Your church is doing pretty well. Can you loan some money?"
你回去，你是不是职务会的？回去帮我们讲一讲，可不可以
？Can you talk with the church council?
我们的教会都是兄弟嘛，大家存钱在银行也是浪费嘛，对不对？
Because all of our churches are brother churches. That if you have money just sitting in the bank, it's a waste too.
那个弟兄突然说，传道，我不是职务会，但是哦。你要借多少？我可以免费的借30万给教会。
And then so this brother said that I am not on the church council, but if you need the help, I can lend $300,000 interest free.
后来我没有跟他借了。
And I did not borrow this money from him.
我只是你不晓得，我听了真的很感动哎，30万不是小钱哎。
But when I heard this, I was very touched because $300,000 is not a small amount.
我怎么有一个弟兄可以说传道教会要我就先给教会用，不用利息十年？
How is a brother that just says that if you need $300,000, I will lend it to the church for no interest for 10 years?
当然我再讲一遍，没有跟他要了。
And I will,
我们教会够，本身的弟兄姐妹的教会都，
And I will reiterate that we did not take this money from him.
但是我很感动。
But I was very moved.
真的神是震动人心的神。
And really, God is a God who moves the hearts
of
men.
我们哦，有时候真的时间到了，发展教会有时候会遇到很多困难。
And so sometimes when we are trying to expand the church, we will meet up with many problems.
我们个人的生命有时候遇到很多困难。
And sometimes in our lives, we meet up with problems.
你可以刚强。
But you can be strong.
你要记得神一而再再而三跟您说你要刚强。
You must remember that God has time and time again said you must be strong.
你要去想他的应许是什么。
You must think what his promises are.
你要去体会他圣灵的力量有多大。
You must experience how great the power of his Holy Spirit is.
你要相信他是一个震动人心的神。
You must believe that he is a God who can move the hearts of men. Let's bow our heads and pray in silence.